Just realised I'm not even rolling. The amount of times I do that.
Hello. Hey guys, Rory here from Your Golf Travel. I'm back at one of my favourite resorts in the UK. I'm here at the Celtic Manor, South Wales, host of the 2010 Ryder Cup, home to three top quality golf courses and a ton of accommodation options, one of which you can see behind me in the form of the Hunter Lodges. Now, I'm sure lots of you know about the big five-star hotel, the four-star manor house as well, but maybe some of you don't know, you can also rent these semi-private, sleeping up to eight little cottages that are situated down on the 2010 course, just overlooking the 15th or 16th fairway, can't remember which one it is. Now usually at Your Golf Travel we would package these bad boys up for the kind of like two nights, three rounds of golf, so one round of golf on each of the courses here at Celtic Manor, as well as two nights in one of these lovely, lovely cottages. And I'm going to show you around one of these places in a minute because they are pretty damn cool. But I'm actually here this week with one of our sister companies, RacingBreaks.com. And any of you with a keen eye on horse racing will know that this week it's the Cheltenham Festival. Now there's always lots of buzz going around the Your Golf Travel office around the Cheltenham Festival. The owners, YGT, are well into their horse racing, they own horses. So this week I've actually come down to attend the festival tomorrow with RacingBreaks.com because they're offering for this year's Cheltenham Festival and for next year the combination of golf plus racing here at Celtic Manor. And I'm going to see what it's all about. Right, first time in one of these Hunter Lodges. I've been wanting to see one of these for ages. Lovely. As I said, these can sleep up to eight people. I think there's four twin or double bedrooms. That's the kind of thing you're looking at here. You've got your own self-catering kitchen if you don't want to go up to the resort for dinner, lunch, whatever you may feel like cooking in there. You've also got, let's have a little look out here, hot tub, yes please. And then heading upstairs, just to give you guys an idea of what we're talking about here. You've got main bathroom, which, oh, hello, has a sauna. Seriously, this place is wicked. And then, yeah, I think just probably another couple of, yeah, twin bedroom. And then, oh, little TV room, just in case you get bored of whatever everyone else is watching downstairs. Then there's your double. All of the bedrooms en suite and very, very nice indeed. This is a really cool little accommodation option here at Celtic Manor. Very, very swish. I'm getting in there later for sure. But yeah, as I was just saying, just to give you an idea of whereabouts these Hunter Lodges are located on the resort. Just over here in the bottom of the valley, we've got the 2010 course. And luckily, I got a tee time there in about half an hour. So I'm gonna take you guys around the course for those of you who haven't played the 2010 yet. It's so, so fun. You're gonna get a little bit of a member for the day experience. It's more than just the golf, but the course itself is fantastic too. So show you as much of that as I can, some of the signature holes obviously, and then when the guys from Racing Breaks get here later, we're going to start thinking about tomorrow and heading to the Cheltenham Festival. First time of me. So part of the fun of a round at the 2010 starts the locker room experience. Now these are the same locker rooms that the guys when the Ryder Cup came here actually used. As you can see when I went into one of the little cubbyhole corners, you've got names of lots of players who were at the event that year. So you've got Martin Keimer, Molinari, well played at the weekend, bro. And then you've got Pia Hansen, Graham McDowell, hold the winning putt here. Miguel,
Luke Donald, a few others dotted around, but I'm going to settle for, I think, the other Rory.
So yeah guys, as I said, part of the 2010 experience is that member for the day type thing. So we've already had our clubs taken off us at the top as you come in, kind of a valet concierge service up there. And I believe the clubs will basically be waiting for us on the first tee or on the driving range, depending on which one you're going to head to first. First tee for me, as you all know. But for now, got to change into my golf shoes and get out there onto that first tee.
Say hello to everyone, Aaron. This is who I'm joined by today, my friend from racingbreaks.com.
How you doing?
I'm just about to get the transfer down to the driving range, or just the first tee? Please say first tee.
Straight to first tee.
Good man. Hey,
not going to mess around with that.
Good, thanks. How are you?
Yeah, great. Thank you.
Good. So today, Aaron is going to explain to us his involvement in Racing Breaks and the kind of matchup between golf and racing packages during the Cheltenham Festival.
So we've started Racing Breaks about 2 years ago, and it's kicked off with Cheltenham Festival being one of the biggest events that we do. And this year we've kind of evolved it to include a bit of golf as well. So we are now hosting almost 1,000 people down at Celtic Manor Resort. The three world-class golf courses. So you basically have a nice little day out on the courses, and then followed by a day at Cheltenham Festival. Obviously, any day you fancy, you can play golf on the Monday, you can play golf on the Wednesday, and off to Cheltenham, whichever day you like as well.
Doing Tuesday. I've not done Cheltenham before, so you're going to have to show me the ropes.
So we're doing Tuesday, which is Champions Day. It's the opening day of the festival, so in my opinion, the best day to go. It's got unbelievable racing, and you're also there for the start, the big Cheltenham famous roar, and when the first race kicks off, just after kind of 1:30 tomorrow. So yeah, but great day, and the weather is amazing today. I'm not convinced it's going to be quite the same tomorrow, but hey ho, that's kind of all part and parcel of Cheltenham Festival.
Have you played the 2010 before?
I have played the 2010 before, a few years ago now, with Your Golf Travel. It was one of the events, and I've actually been down with friends before, just for some weekends away playing golf. So this will be my, I think, my third time playing. First two didn't go so well, so fingers crossed, third time lucky.
We've never played well together either, so
no, that's very true.
Thank you,
James. Windy today, which is actually fairly common for the 2010, part of the challenge here for sure. So we decided to go off the yellow tees, which brings the course to about 6,500 yards. It's about 6,900, about 7,000 off the back there, and in this wind that ain't going to be too much fun. So we're going to do yellow tees, we're going to keep a little match going throughout. We're not going to show you all the holes, probably just some of the signature ones. But Aaron, what are you playing off?
Suspect 11 today.
A suspect 11, so there you go. There's a bit of a tradition of suspect handicaps going around. I get a lot of abuse from mine on the internet, so I'm sure you're probably going to get some today as well.
Oh, undoubtedly. I'll be 11 over after four holes.
Right, so first hole, par 4, dog leg straight down to the left. Here we go. Perfect, I think. Caught that a bit skinny, but considering my usual wedge game, happy with that. Middle of the green, got away with it. But yeah, I guess the first question to ask on this video is this sort of thing something that you'd be tempted to do? How keen are you guys on the horse racing? And have you ever thought of packaging up something as fun as the Cheltenham Festival with a few rounds of golf here at Celtic Manor or Marriott St Pierre, anywhere else on the South Wales coast that would logistically work. Yeah, have you ever thought about it? Post some comments down below. As I said, got away with that one. Aaron just short right, but both probably putting. Right, Aaron's gone one up there through two, had a shot in the second, par five, straight down the wind. Made a nice 6-5, we both hit pretty average second shots to kind of drop shots there, but just spinning round onto one of the prettiest holes in the opening nine, the third, the par three. Bit of a beast today, 176 in the yellows, the wind is coming straight into. So it's going to be all of a long iron, and it's just water, 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 which is fairly indicative of a lot of the holes here on the 2010.
That'll work.
That's a great little shot. That's right on
there. Go in.
Oh. Terrific shot.
Thank you.
Right guys, so just got to the sixth tee here on the 2010 course, and this is what I would call the first of the signature holes, well, as far as I'm concerned anyway. As you can see, par four sweeping up there with water all the way down the right, green kind of curving around onto a little kind of half peninsula. What feels like a long, long way away today with this wind. But yeah, fingers crossed with wind off the left, our ball doesn't go in that drink on the right, but odds on, I reckon it's happening.
I think that's fine.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh my god, that's the bunkers are so much further than I thought.
Yeah, that was ripped as well.
Oh my god. I genuinely thought that was like 30 yards into the trees. Oh wow, that is completely changed where I'm aiming. No wonder I keep getting in the water. Right, it's just the bunkers then.
Yeah. Middle of the two bunkers is a good line. There, that's perfect. Is it not?
Could be good.
Yeah, well done, middle of the fairway. Right, Aaron, I need you to manage my expectations for me for tomorrow. So the only experience I've had of racing really is Royal Ascot in a box when I was about 9 years old.
It's a nice way of doing racing. Cheltenham, yeah, completely different. It's the highlight of the season for jumps fans. It's better than Christmas, yeah. Better than birthdays, all rolled into one. It's the crowds are humongous, yeah. The roars are enormous.
Bit less formal than Ascot?
Much less formal.
Yeah.
People still like to dress up and take care of what they look like. Yeah. But you can go in jeans, you can go in a shirt, you can go in a t-shirt if you really want to. Most people like to wear a little bit of tweed, maybe stick a little hat on,
yeah.
And dress up for the occasion. But
well, I've got a tweed suit as it happens.
Very nice, very nice.
But I also won when I went to Ascot that time when I was about 10. I think I won like 20 quid off a 50p bet, so my expectations in terms of betting is that I'm just going to win every better place tomorrow.
Yeah, I mean, you'd hope so. We've got a nice little preview panel with some celebs and some tipsters in our VIP lounge, so that should help you.
Cool.
But then the one tip I'd always say is if someone says they know what's going to win, don't believe them.
Fair enough. Cool, let's go and find those balls, shall we? So as you can see, at my ball here in the sixth, just semi-rough. As you can see, it's such a great hole because these fairway bunkers, and that's where Aaron's driven it to, he's a long dog, they really pinch in with the water here on the right, so the longer you get up the hole, the tighter that fairway gets. And it's a fairly long hole off these tees that we're playing off today, and there are a couple of other tee positions behind us as well, so this can be a real brute, especially if the wind's straight back into. So you do kind of want to get as far up as you can, but like I said, that makes that fairway more and more narrow. Nice shot in, Aaron. Very good. We'll forget the fact that I was hacking my way up the left there and just watch you roll it in for a birdie. But officially, you're already back to one up. Oh, yes. That's a hell of a three on that hole, to be fair. yeah, guys, that sixth hole is 2010 all over for me. This is actually the first ever golf course to be completely purpose-built for the Ryder Cup. Cool little fact, which I'm pretty sure is correct. But as you can see in between the holes, there's so much space to fit the crowds in 2010. And the mounding, obviously, as well, which is lining a lot of the fairways here, obviously built so the spectators can get a good vantage point. But sixth hole for me, first of the signature holes, water all the way up the right, proper stadium feel. But yeah, that's pretty much the 2010 in a nutshell. But there's plenty more good holes, which I'll show you later. How many is that? One, drop two, three, four. Is that five? Six, five, six in?
Three, four, five, yeah, six in.
Pretty good with a drop.
Thank you.
Your golf travel goes one up.
The first time.
Yeah.
All day breakfast back to.
I do a
hot snack.
Sausage sandwich, I think. Burger. You get, do you have like proper food? Or you get...
I might get a quarter pounder, yeah.
Yeah, might do a quarter pounder as well.
Or maybe a half pounder. How greedy am I feeling?
Hi there, mate. Can we order two quarter pounders, please? With onions and bacon on. No onions, no worries, just bacon then. Great, thanks.
So that's one of the fun things about the 2010 here, ordering on the 10th tee, and then the halfway house is on the other side of the green, so our food should be ready, nice and hot for when we get there, no waiting around. Right, we've made an executive decision, we're going to call it after two more holes. As I said earlier, we do have a little bit of work to do, so 18 was never the plan today, unfortunately. But yeah, just this little section of the course right now, we're on the 12th tee. This is what I think is the best stretch of holes on the golf course. You've got 12 here, which are par 4, straight down there. Water left, and then further up you've got water right with a nice upturned source of green, lots of runoffs, good bunkering, stunning hole. And then the one after that is basically following exactly the same direction. It's par 3 over the water, one of the most picturesque par 3s on the resort, and that includes the Montgomery and the Roman Road as well. I don't think we're going to get a chance to play it, but 14 is also one of the best par 4s on the course. So again, from earlier points that I made, this is kind of what you expect from Celtic Manor 2010 course. It's just stadium, big bunkering, nice big drop-offs around the greens, and lots of water.
Oh, last ball.
Gosh. Ooh. Oh, it goes quite a long way though.
Good?
Yeah, good.
Definite splash ball off the tee for me. Aaron sitting pretty in the middle of the fairway. Oh, massive tripod kick. Could be going all square with one to go, Aaron.
Fingers crossed.
Right, all square, one hole to go. Gorgeous little par three over the water. I'm calling a YGT win here, Aaron. I called it.
You've done well on the par three so far. But...
So just before we take on this hole, how many times have you been or done Cheltenham? You're a bit of a vet, aren't you?
About a half dozen times now, and within that's probably doing 2-3 days each time. So I've got to have done almost 20 days of Cheltenham.
How many days of racing is there if you do the whole
four
thing?
4 days, so it's Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Same week in March every year. Starts on Champions Day, goes through Ladies Day, then St Patrick's Day, always a good one.
Yeah.
And then the big one in theory is Friday with the Gold Cup.
And presumably doing all 4 days is tough.
It's tough. Most people do it. We've got Alan Brazil in the lounge tomorrow who does 4 days every year and absolutely loves it. Yeah. Everyone has their little traditions, how they do Cheltenham. Different ways of doing it. Obviously we're doing it a slightly different way this year with golf, but lots of people tend to do.
You're saying your optimum is what, 2 days?
I think 2 days is nice. I get sneered at by some of the hardcore people, but I think Tuesday, Wednesday is always a good way to do it. Or then potentially maybe do Thursday, Friday, finish with the Gold Cup day.
Cool. All right, let's see this tee shot. Water ball. Water ball me up.
No idea about club here.
What you got?
Seven.
Yeah, me too.
too much.
That? Big.
Yeah, it was dry.
Way big.
Had the 8 in the other hand.
All on this then, eh?
Oh, short game competition between me and you is going to be a bit embarrassing.
I suppose it's only right to half the inaugural Racing Brakes versus your Golf Travel Challenge through 12 holes. Right, thank you, sir.
Cheers, mate.
Let's get inside into that clubhouse.
Yeah, go. Be it.
Right, so that's all part of the service here on the 2010 course as well. I dropped my clubs off when we finished around the back. They've since been cleaned by lovely attendants here at the 2010, and they're just waiting for me outside the front door, so I'm gonna hop in the car now, head back to the lodge and get ready for the racing tomorrow. Oh yeah. Right guys, back at the Hunter Lodge. We're actually number 7, which is quite funny. Don't put hashtag on it, but oh well. Gonna get a good night's sleep tonight, I think. Gonna cook some dinner for the guys, and then yeah, hit the sack, because tomorrow should be a very long but very fun day, heading into the Racing Brakes VIP lounge at the Cheltenham Festival, which basically entails free bar all day, no queuing, bit of shelter from the weather, because it's supposed to be not a great day tomorrow, which is a bit unfortunate. TV screens everywhere, VIP celebrity panel doing tips as a betting service. So yeah, I'm gonna set myself a budget and not allow myself to go over it in terms of bets. And then, yeah, joy days racing at the Cheltenham Festival. Never done it before, but see you guys tomorrow. Racing Brakes VIP lounge, and as you can see behind me, it is not the best of days here at Cheltenham, but there's a load of people in here. There must be at least 100 or so. Lee West was just popped in, he might be back later.
Hello.
We've got Alan Brazil, we've got various other celebrities giving their pro tips on the races today. So I'm looking forward to getting stuck in. It's my first day ever at Cheltenham, as I said. Yeah, shame about the weather. I'm not going to be able to go outside and explore too much, but I don't think I can take the camera out there anyway. So I'm just here to give you an idea of what the Racing Brakes VIP lounge is all about. Hopefully I'll be back in some winter's day and having a lot of fun.
Is this the one to go for?
We're all over Glenporsche.
Well, I'm going to bet on something else, then, otherwise it's boring, isn't it?
I'm going to go hardline.
Fiver on hardline. That's my decision. I'm doing it.
Oh yeah, can I put a fiver on hardline in the second race, please?
Let's do this properly. No each way.
Not messing about.
No. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Gone,
my horse.
Oh my god.
Come on, hardline.
Lee Westwood, you owe me £5, bro. Yeah,
running on that horse that just took a nosedive over the final fence. I didn't win any money, but I'm not as, you know, upset as a lot of people in here. It's all a little bit awkward. Horse just came in second, didn't bet it each way.
I'm not gonna lie, it was all getting a little bit loose in the VIP lounge by the time I left, so put the camera away. But to sum up, a couple of days with Racing Breaks was a hell of a lot of fun. 2010 course is always a pleasure to play. Really, really impressed with the Hunter Lodges at Celtic Manor as well. 100% something I'd like to do with a group of mates. Go and do a couple of nights there and play all three golf courses at the resort. And my day at Cheltenham, yeah, really, really fun. I think I got pretty unlucky with the weather. It wasn't the nicest of days. People I've spoken to who went last year were telling me all about how lovely and sunny it was, so got a bit unlucky there, but yeah, hell of a lot of fun anyway. I think all told, I placed about 5 bets, and thankfully on my very last bet of the day, my horse came in, and it was actually one of you guys on Twitter who told me to put the money down on that horse, so thank you very much. Came in, and basically I broke exactly even. I think I might have made like £1.50 profit on the day. So yeah, breaking even is always good when you're putting down that many bets. And as I said at the start of the video, is a bit of golf and a bit of racing the kind of thing that you'd be up for next year, potentially? You never know, I might host a group down at Celtic Manor, take you guys out to the Cheltenham Festival with my friends at Racing Breaks. Post some comments down below if that's the sort of thing that you'd be up for. Anyone got any questions about my experience this year, fire some comments in there as well. And just to give you an idea on the cost, I asked Aaron at the start of the day how much a 2-night dinner, bed and breakfast, 1 round of golf and a day at the Cheltenham Festival will set you back, and it's around the £200 mark, which I think is exceptional value for money, considering not only the quality of golf courses and the accommodation at Celtic Manor, but also a day at the races too. So yeah, a bit of an odd video this one, obviously not entirely golf related, but if you enjoyed it, do the usual, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I will see you guys soon with some more regular action just from the golf course.